Raise up your hand to the Lord.
And
we're going to pray. The power of God is going to begin to move. From the very beginning, as you hear the word of God, something great will happen to you. And then when we finish the preaching, and then we begin the prayer. Because tonight, the prayer is for you. You will not escape miracle. You will not escape the power of God. Something wonderfully miraculous will come upon your life. Raise up those hands and let's anoint the hand with power. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you tonight. We bless your name tonight. We come, Lord, before you, knowing that with you all things are possible. We're asking, Lord, you open the windows of heaven. Send your power down. And Lord, I pray, you will touch every life. You will turn every life around. There will be transformation. There will be a mighty change. There will be a miraculous change. The freedom will come to everyone in Jesus' name. Open every prison door. And let your people come out of the cage of the enemy. Set the captives free. Save the souls of your creatures. And heal their bodies. And tonight I pray they will never be the same again. Freedom, liberty, deliverance, dominion, miracles, signs and wonders confirm in every life. We thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name I pray. Thank you very much. You can sit down. I'm talking to you tonight on the wonder of a glorious freedom. The wonder of a glorious freedom. You see, when God created Adam and Eve, when he created man and woman, he made them free. They were completely free. All the creatures of God, as you come from the hands of God, he wants you to be free. He wants you to be totally liberated, free from every concern. The things that concern you today and the things that bother you today, he wants you to be totally, completely, entirely free. And thank God you are there tonight. I'm talking to somebody there. I said I'm talking to somebody there. Thank God you are there tonight. A day of freedom has come for you. Your destiny is a destiny of freedom. And you came here tonight. Every negative thing will turn positive. If you are already inside a cage, in captivity, in the prison of the enemy, the door is open. You will come out. Am I talking to you? Am I talking to somebody there? I said tonight, you are free in Jesus' name. You know, when Adam and Eve, when they were created, they were free. Free from sin. Free from oppression. Free from sickness. Free from fear. They were free from suffering. They were free from pain. They were free from affliction. They were completely free from sorrow. They were free from poverty. They were free from slavery. They were free from satanic attacks and afflictions. How we see then that the offering of spring of Adam, how we see that those of us who came after, all these things played plague our lives. We're not free. What happened? Because Satan came in.
Toripe Satani Wolewa.
He came to Eve.
O waso do Efa.
Came to Adam.
O waso do Adamo.
He came to the family.
O wasinu ebina.
Came to the garden.
O wasinu ogbana.
The habitation of Adam and Eve.
Ni biti Adamo ate Efa
ngbe. He came to the garden.
O wasinu ogbana.
The business place of Adam and Eve.
Ni biti Adamo ate Efa
ngbe. He came to the children.
O wasinu e
the children of Adam and Eve.
Iru omo Adamo ate Efa.
He came to the community.
O wasi adugo na.
The community of Adam and Eve.
Adugo Adamo ate Efa.
And he stole their freedom.
O wa ji ominira won.
So the rest of the people of the world, in the family of Adam and Eve, in the community of Adam and Eve, in the world of Adam and Eve, we have lost freedom. But thank God tonight. Somebody there, I said, praise God tonight. Somebody there, I said, thank God tonight. Jesus was watching. He saw how the devil came. He saw what we lost. He saw there was no freedom. And he said, Father, talking to the Almighty, he said, Father, your creatures now in captivity, I want to go down there and set them free. Set them free. Free from sin. Free from fear. Free from suffering. Free from sickness. Free from poverty. Free from affliction. I want to go there and set them free. I will bear their problem. I will carry them. I will take them out of the cage of the devil. And one glorious day, Jesus came. I want to announce to you, Emmanuel has arrived. His name is Emmanuel. God with us. Satan is no match for Emmanuel. Evil spirits are no match for Emmanuel. Your sickness is no match for Emmanuel. Your poverty is no match for Emmanuel. Emmanuel has come. Somebody raise your hand and welcome Emmanuel. Somebody wave that hand and praise the Lord. Emmanuel has arrived. He's coming to you right there. Somebody there. He's coming to you right there. See, all these problems I've been crying about, the time has come. An end has come. When Jesus came, it didn't take time. He began to touch the blind eyes. He began to let the lame rise up and walk. As Jesus came, he came to manifest the power of the Almighty. Anytime the evil spirit saw him, before he even spoke at all, he began to cry out. He said, Jesus, Jesus of Nazareth, the Holy One of God, have you come to torment us? One word, come out. They all came out. This is your night. I said, this is your night. My freedom has come. Somebody there, my freedom has come. One man there, my freedom has come. That woman there, my freedom has come. This is the day. And this is the hour. It's coming your way. I said it's coming your way. Wipe away those tears. Take away that sorrow. Oppression is coming to an end. Sin is coming to an end. And that Satan that has tormented your life, the pronouncement of heaven is coming against that enemy. Tonight I am free. Tonight I am free. My prison doors are open. Now that I know the truth, I am free. I am free. I am free indeed. It will come upon your life in Jesus' name. The wonder of a glorious freedom. I'm going to divide the message to three parts. 1, 2, 3.
After
when I finish point 3, and it will not be long. 1, 2, 3. Heaven will open for you. Your door will open. That will be the time. Hey, come on, wait. We're not here for another person. We're here for you. Where are you? I said, where are you? And somebody said, I go to church. You have been going to church. I go to deeper life. Thank God you go to deeper life. I go to this other church. Have you got everything? I said, have you got everything? I'm telling you that you came here today so that your destiny tonight will change. I am there,
so
I'm forgetting about that now. We just want to open the door and release you to something you never had in your life before. Tonight, miracle. Somebody shout miracle. Number one, the marvel of freedom from sin. It is something surprising. As sin has tied somebody ready to bundle him and throw him to the bottomless pit, Jesus comes and says, stop. He is not material for hellfire. He is not material for the devil. He is not material for perdition. And the devil will stop tonight in your life. Stop. You cannot cast him to hell. I came to save him. Somebody is getting saved tonight. Somebody there. Praise the Lord. The devil thought, you come to the edge. You've committed too many sins. Private, secret, public. You've done too many things. And he's trying to tie you up. And throw you to hellfire. Stop! It's not a material for hellfire. Somebody is going to get to heaven there. Somebody there. Somebody there. You're not a candidate for hellfire. Heaven is your destiny. Eternal life is your destiny. Heaven, you are going there. Because Jesus comes in between you and Satan. The marvel of freedom from sin. Number two is a miracle of freedom from sickness. It is the devil. He gives you a particular thing so that all the money you have earned in your life, you will spend it upon an hospital. It is the devil's plan. So that as you have now collected a lot of money, you have finished your business and everything, to sit down to begin to enjoy, it brings sickness. Instead of laughter, sorrow, and weeping. But Jesus comes tonight. He said, I have a miracle waiting for you. Somebody there. A miracle with your name. Where are you? The angels are looking for you. Where are you? Jesus is looking for you. A miracle. A miracle. Somebody there. Are you there? A miracle. You will have it tonight in Jesus' name. Number three, the manifestation of freedom from Satan. The manifestation of freedom from Satan. Once you are free from those three, sin, sickness, Satan, You'll be an achiever. You'll be a victor. You'll be a conqueror. That's why tonight freedom has come. Are you there? Are you tired of freedom? I said your freedom now has come. Point number one. The marvel of freedom from sin. Actually, when we say sin, many people don't understand. And they think, they don't want you to enjoy life. Let me show you. In Proverbs chapter 5, verse 22, Satan will never let you know this. The people around you will not allow you to know this. Even your own mind, your own conscience will not allow you to know this, because Satan wants to use that sin to bind you up, to tie you up, and to rope you around, so that your hands will not be active, your feet will not be active, your mind will not be alert, your brain will not function, you will not know the consequence of what you are doing. Look at it. Proverbs chapter 5, verse 22. His own iniquity shall take the wicked himself. He shall be holding, he shall be bound, he shall be tied with the cords of his sins. It is what the devil uses to tie you. You call it enjoyment. And Satan will say, enjoy, enjoy, enjoy. And the more you do that thing, the more it ties up your brain. The more it ties up your mind. The more it ties your hand. The more he deadens your conscience. The more he blocks your vision. Because the sin that evil deed is something that ties you and binds you up, and you cannot make progress. The veil is taken away from your face tonight. Are you there?
So
I said the veil is taken away from your face tonight. He will not allow you to sleep in the night. He said, wake up and go and do that thing there. Wake up. And go and do that thing over there. Where you should be sleeping. So that your energy will come back. So that you'll be refreshed in the morning. In the day, you're awake. In the night, you're awake. It's cutting your life. Cutting your life. Cutting your life. So that you will die prematurely. Tonight, your eyes are opened. And all the bondage of the devil, all the cords of the devil with which he has tied you, you are loose tonight. You are free in Jesus' name. How do you become free? I said, how do you become free? It's in John chapter 8. Thank God, name is Jesus. Thank God, he is Lord. Thank God, he is Savior. If you come to him, he will set you free. If you believe in him, he will set you free. He will give you, number one, he'll give you forgiveness. All the guilt, all the condemnation, everything will vanish away. Number one, forgiveness. Number two, he said, don't go yet, don't go yet. Freedom. 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 Number three, don't go yet. He'll give you favor. The favor of heaven will be upon your life. The goodness of God will pour upon your life. The riches of glory will come upon your life. Your soul, you'll be free. Your spirit, you'll be free. Your mind, you'll be free. Your brain, you'll be free. Your body, you'll be free. Your legs will be free. He will make you whole. In John chapter 8. 36. John chapter 8. Verse 36. If the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. He said, number one, you will be free. Number two, you'll be free indeed. 100% free. Totally free. Completely free. There'll be no yoke in your life. There'll be no curse in your life. There'll be no calamity in your life. The Lord will be clearing the way for you everywhere you're going.
Let's
go on and succeed. Go on and be happy. Go on and be joyful. Go on and prosper. Somebody there. Jesus is coming. Because if the Son shall make you free. Where are you? I said, where are you? You want freedom. Total freedom. Complete freedom. You know somebody. They almost broke his head because of fighting. And he said, God, I will never fight again. They could have killed me. That man broke the bottle like this. And he was about to slap me. And God just delivered me. God, I will never fight again. And then 1 week after, there was no fight. There was no conflict. Why is everything quiet? Why is everybody just going like this and asleep? They don't know how to fight. And he started again. My friend, you said you'll not fight anymore. No, if you are a man, you must fight. And until somebody took a rod and wanted to smash it on his head, and God delivered him again. But he doesn't want to fight. But he keeps on fighting. That sin inside you, that the devil has planted inside you to kill you, that sin, God will take it away from you today. Somebody. I'm looking for him. I'm looking for her there. Your marriage will not scatter. Your family will not scatter. Fighting will not scatter your family. Where are you? You will be free tonight. I said you'll be free tonight. Because if the Son, if the Savior, if the Master, if the Messiah, if Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. He will forgive your sin. He will give you salvation. You'll be free from guilt and condemnation. You'll be free from the suffering that comes as a result of sin. You will be free from connection with the devil. Connection with the devil on earth. Connection with the devil in hell. You will not follow Satan to hell. I said you will not follow Satan to hell. The cord that ties you with Satan. And is running a relay race to get to hell. That cord that ties you with Satan is broken tonight. Free. Free from hell. Free from punishment. Point number two. The miracle of freedom from sickness. Wonderful. Wonderful wonders. See that blind man, they will see the eyes opening tonight. Rising up and walking tonight. And those broken bones are joined together tonight. See that person with madness, fire burning in your brain. And tonight freedom has come. Because there's a miracle. The supernatural power of God touching you to set you free. Because tonight is your night. If I'm talking about you, say it yourself. Tonight is my night. Tonight is the night of freedom from sickness. Total deliverance. Look at Mark chapter 7. Mark chapter 7. Look at verse 34. And he looking up to heaven sighed and said unto him, Ephrathah, that he is be opened. Just two words. Be opened. Look at verse 35. And straightway his ears were opened. And the string of his tongue was loosed. And he spake plain tonight. Be opened. Your ears will open. Your eyes will open. Be opened. Your destiny will open. Be opened. And the cage in which you are, that cage will open. Just two words, be healed. And you are healed. You are healed. Be free. And you are free. We're not going to, you know, talk and pray. Just two words. Be healed. You've got it. Be delivered and it is done. Rise up and walk and it is done. That's what Jesus always did. Just two words. Just a few words. Come out of him. That evil spirit will come out. And when that command comes tonight, that tumor come out. It will come out. That swelling come out. It will come out. Blind eyes be open. It will be open. You will rise up and walk. You will receive strength tonight. Because this is how Jesus did it. And he passed it on to his ministers. And he said, everywhere you go, preach the gospel, heal the sick, and tell them their time of freedom has come. And Jesus Christ is the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. And he said, whatsoever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatsoever you lose on earth will be loosed in heaven. I'm going to give the word of authority, anointing, and command unto you. And I say, be free. It is confirmed in heaven. It will be confirmed in heaven. Be healed. It will be confirmed in heaven. Somebody there. You are having a miracle tonight. Somebody there. Your incurable disease is going to be healed tonight. The end of that chapter 7 of Mark. That's verse 37. And they were beyond measure astonished, saying, he has done all things well. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Tonight, he will do all things well. In your life, in your heart, in your family. To you tonight, he said, I am your Lord. I come to set you free. Are you getting ready for him?
So Timura Silady.
I said, are you getting ready for him?
So Timura Silady.
It will come upon your life in Jesus' name.
Yo, one aye, waloruko Jesu.
Number one.
Akoko.
The marvel of freedom from sin.
Iyano didio mrabalo wese.
Number two.
Ekeji.
The miracle of freedom from sickness.
Ise iyano didio mrabalo wese.
Number three.
Iketa.
The manifestation of freedom from Satan.
Ifaraha didio mrabalo wo Satani.
Manifestation tonight.
Ifaraha lalei.
Demonstration tonight. The power of God will be demonstrated in your life. See, look at it in Luke chapter 13. I'm reading from verse 16. Luke chapter 13, verse 16. Ought not this woman
Be
a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan has bound. Look, these 80 years. Be loosed from this bond on the Sabbath day. Ought not this man, being a creature of the Almighty God, whom Satan has bound, be loosed on this very day? Ought not this woman, being the handiwork of the Almighty God, whom Satan has bound, be loosed and set free on this glorious day? Ought not the sinner, being a creature of God, whom Satan has bound all these many years, be loosed on this day of freedom? God created you. He created you not for Satan. He created you not for occultism. He created you not for evil spirits. He created you for himself. But the devil has turned your eyes and your face away. And the devil has bound you. But tonight, are you there?
So si wambe.
I said tonight. Praise God. I said tonight.
Hallelujah. Moni lalei.
Wonderful. I said tonight.
Iyanu ni omoni lalei.
Your freedom has come now.
Ominira re ti de bayi.
Because Jesus Christ has come.
Tori pe Jesu Kristi ti de.
He said, I came for you.
Oni tori e mo se wa.
He came for you.
O wa fun o.
He came for you.
O wa fun o.
And that freedom is coming.
Ominira yen si nbo.
I will be free.
Emi o dominira.
Say it for yourself.
So fun ara re.
I will be free.
Emi nwo dominira.
I said, I will be free.
Mo le mi o.
Jesus set her free.
Jesus saw dominira.
And he's still the same. He has not changed. And he will set you free. And he said, ought not this person be free? Freedom. If he's coming your way, where are you? Freedom. Ought not this person with the hands raised up be free? Ought not this person there raising and waving the hand be free? Heaven confirms you are going to be free. God confirms you are going to be free. Jesus confirms you are going to be free.
Yes, for what's it, we are doing.
Calvary confirms you are going to be free.
Calvary for what's it, we are doing.
The cross of Jesus Christ has come to cancel your curse, has come to cancel your sin, has come to cancel your sickness, has come to cancel the power of Satan in your life. Free,
Ominira.
Free,
Ominira.
Free.
Diominira.
It's coming your way right now. Free from sin. Free from sickness. And free from Satan. You ought to be free. You must be free. Your time is here. The power of God is here. This is the moment of your freedom. Heads bowed and eyes closed. Heads bowed and eyes closed. This is the moment right now. And the Lord is going to perform that operation of freedom in your life. Every chain, it will break. Every cord, it will snap. All the fetters, it will loose. And your soul that is bound. Bound to sin. Bound to Satan. This is the moment of your freedom. It's about the nice clothes. If you want Christ to set you free, set you free from sin. If you want Christ to set you free from that cord of sin that binds you, if this is your night, if this is the moment of your freedom, and you say, I'll be free. Tonight I'll be free. If you want to be free with the freedom Jesus Christ has brought, you will raise up your hand wherever you are. You say, yes, I am here. A candidate for freedom. A candidate for freedom. A candidate for freedom. Anywhere you are now, don't look at any other sin. Don't look at any other person. It's me. It's me. It's me. I want freedom from Christ. You raise up your hand. If you're raising up your hand, and you're saying, I want to be free from my sin. Satan will not bind me with this sin and take me to hellfire. If that is you raise up your hand, I want to be free. Tonight I want to be free. Tonight I want to be free. You raise up your hand, you stand up. Your freedom has come. Don't delay your freedom. You will stand up. You say, yes, Lord, I come. Yes, Lord, I come. Yes, Lord, I come. I quit the work of Satan. I quit the work of Satan. I quit the partnership with Satan. I come to Jesus, my Savior. Wherever you are, I want Jesus to break that yoke of sin. You raise up the hand, you stand up. If you are standing up, you leave where you are. Take your Bible, take your bag, whatever you have there. Come right here to Jesus. Come right here to Jesus. As you come, and you move your legs, one, two, one, two, one, two. You say, bye bye, Satan. Bye bye, darkness. Bye bye, sin. Bye bye, evil. Bye bye, bondage. Keep on coming, keep on coming. You're coming to Christ. You say, Jesus, I come. Jesus, I come. Keep on coming. Come out. Come to Jesus. Don't stay behind. Your freedom is right here. Your forgiveness is right here. Your salvation is right here. The forgiveness is right here. Freedom. Freedom. Your freedom is right here. We're going to pray. You pray after me now in English. You say from the depths of your heart. And you say it with assurance, determination, and confidence. If you totally repent and you are coming to Christ, you say this out of the depths of your heart. Are you ready? I can't hear you. Almighty God, I thank you today. Today is my day of freedom. Lord, I come out. Out of sin. Out of bondage. Out of occultism. Out of evil. Jesus, you are my Savior. I come to you. Lord Jesus, I believe you died for me. You shed your blood for me, for my freedom, for my forgiveness, for my freedom, for my salvation. And Lord, I come today. I will not go back. I will not go back to Satan. I will not go back to my sin. I receive Jesus as my personal Savior. I know you are standing at the door of my heart. I open the door of my heart. Come in. Come in. Come in today. Come in to stay. And abide with me forever. And when I finish on this earth, I will not go to hell. I will go with Jesus to heaven. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I am forgiven. Thank you, Lord. I am free. Thank you, Lord. I am saved. In Jesus' name I pray. Keep up that and I'm going to pray with you now. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you because this is the day of freedom, the day of salvation, the day of forgiveness. Lord, I pray all these who have come to Christ, give them your salvation in Jesus' name. I pray, Lord, they will not perish. They will not go to hell. They will get to heaven. Set them free. Free from sin. Set them free. Free from bad habits. Set them free. Free from works of darkness. And Lord, I pray, you give them the grace and the power to go and live in newness of life. I thank you because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name I pray. Put your hands together for Jesus. Praise the Lord. Somebody there is getting totally free now. All that sickness will go. Blindness will vanish away. All the things that bother you, all the sicknesses in your body, now. Somebody there, I said now. Wait. If you need a miracle, if you are waiting for healing, if you are waiting for deliverance, if you want that supernatural power to come upon you right now, you will raise up one hand. You lay the other hand where you have the problem. It is going. Can I have an amen there? Get ready. When you hear the final amen, you check up yourself, the miracle would have arrived there. Father, I thank you for this glorious day. The day of miraculous healing and the day of marvelous deliverance. People, send forth your power. Touch your people. Heal them right now. Destroy the works of the devil. Lord, I pray, as we hear the final amen, on the left miracle, on the right miracle, in front of me miracle, confirm it in Jesus' name. I pray for that person with the infirmity of insanity. I command that insanity come out in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have any swelling in their body. Whatever the cause of the swelling, I command that swelling come out in Jesus' name. Fibroid come out. Tumor come out. Brain that is filled with water, that water come out in Jesus' name. Elephantiasis come out in Jesus' name. That swollen tummy come out in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have any pain in their body. The pain of cancer, be healed in Jesus' name. The pain of ulcer, be healed in Jesus' name. Any pain of any sickness there, in your body, in your bone, I command that pain come out in Jesus' name. Whatever it is, that is your blood dry up right now. That pile be healed in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray that asthma be healed in Jesus' name. Tuberculosis be healed in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have arthritis in your joints, in your bone. I command the arthritis be healed in Jesus' name. Those who are deaf and dumb, I pray the power of God will touch your ears right now. Deaf ears be opened. Dumb tongues be loosed. Begin to hear, begin to speak in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are blind. Those blind eyes, I command you, be opened and begin to see in Jesus' name. Cataract come out in Jesus' name. That glaucoma come out in Jesus' name. All the darkness in your eyesight, all the dimness in your eyesight, clear out of the way in Jesus' name. Receive your sight. Receive your vision. Open your eyes and see. Lord, confirm it in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who are lame. I pray for those who are polio. Those who are stroke. I send for the power of God on your body right now. Receive your healing. Receive your miracle. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name. Those broken bones, be healed right now in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I pray, everyone now without exception, to the left, to the right, to the center, the back, in the front, healing everywhere, deliverance everywhere, miracles everywhere. Lord, remove every yoke in their lives. Set them free. Set them free. Free from sickness. Free from evil spirits. Free from Satan. Free from curse. Free from yoke. Set your people free. Confirm it in every life. I thank you because I know it's not. In Jesus' name I pray. It is done. It is done. Whatever you could not do before, rise up and do it. If you were not seeing before, now you can open your eyes and see. If you brought anybody deaf and dumb, speak to them, speak to them. They will hear what you say. They will repeat what you say. If you were on crutches before, leave those crutches. Get up and walk. If you have any swelling in your body before, check up now, you are well. Whatever the problem was, check it up. You're free. You're free. I said you're free. And then as you see the freedom, you will shall praise the Lord. We are here to rejoice with you.